All right, my man, state your name. Let them know you on Nicavelli TV.
Hey, what's up, Nicavelli TV? It's your boy, Shubovelli, second time around.
All right, and we here to talk about these New York Knicks, as we all know. Let's get into it, man. Now, New York Knicks started off...
Started off good.
Yeah. From last year, when we had Dave Fizdale, around the same time, it was 1-8. This year, we found ourselves in 5-3, when we was 1-8.
Got hyped.
I don't know about hype, but New Yorkers, we seen something. Absolutely. Now we going through the trenches again, man. I think we lost like three, four straight. You know? We had a little high roller, you know, we beat Utah, we beat Indiana, we beat Cleveland.
Teams that we should have beat, that we wasn't expected to beat.
Right. Now we got teams that everybody thought we was gonna run through, like Charlotte, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
OKC, mm-hmm. And things is going downhill. What you think is the formula to get things back on track?
Ooh, that's a tough one, man. You know what I mean? We're talking about the New York Knicks here. But I just think you know what I mean? They gotta play together, camaraderie. You know what I mean? They gotta start playing well with each other. You know, I think we're doing well. I mean, it's weird. I really don't really be watching basketball, but I've been paying attention this year. And shit, man, we need a point guard, man.
So you're not really sold on quickly as of yet, man. You're quickly.
Nah, man, we still got a lot more to do, man. You know what I mean? We need a bench. You know what I mean? We gotta get somebody to ball. You know, I'm actually impressed by him. I'm impressed by Kevin Knox. He's been playing better. His shooting has gotten much better. You know
from
what
the
mean?
Three ball, right?
That three ball. He's been hitting that. She's been hitting it. I'm gonna give him now. I'm gonna give everybody. But you know what's the problem is? We got Julius Randle, who's a four, playing a point guard. It's not gonna work like that. The ball got to be constantly moved around because we don't have that point guard. How you doing, ladies? We don't have that situation when we got point guard. We got a point guard. We ain't got a point guard. So, but Julius is playing a four. He's playing at an all star. He's doing all star numbers, but he can't. He got to move that rock, and we ain't moving that rock fast enough. You know what I mean? We got to play.
So you don't like what he's doing this year, as opposed to last year?
I mean,
when he was turning the rock over. I mean,
he turning over now. He's turning that ball over again. So he's back in the same spot. I think he's coming to in his own now, where he got to learn to be more stronger. Speak up. You know what I mean? Because your actions lead with your play. You know what I mean? You got to make other people step up. You know what I mean? You got a bunch of young guys on that team that need a figure. And even though Julius is still relatively young, he's been in the league now for like 6 years. So it's like, I don't know, man. We got to do something, man. The whole NBA is changing. You know what I mean? I don't understand how everybody get blockbuster deals except us, man. You see what happened with the Nets the other day?
Man, that's a whole nother. Yeah, but I'm hearing they got Harden now. Hearing Kyrie and Kevin Durant.
They fucked that package up too, though.
Yo, good. I'm happy that shit is going down like that. Because they gave Kevin Durant $164 million for 4 years.
Kyrie.
He's only playing for two.
Yeah.
Out that four. So he got some free money out the deal. Mm-hmm. Way to go. Thumbs up. Dumbasses. I love it. Then you got Kyrie Irving. Right?
Nutcase.
Yeah, he want to go to a COVID party instead of sticking with his team.
Yeah.
Him and Kevin Durant ain't talking.
I'm 1,000 with you. I never liked KD or Kyrie.
Okay, so you know, ain't no love lost here.
Yeah.
I was thinking of the best.
Kevin's nice, though.
I give him that. I was thinking for the best interest of the Knicks.
Yeah.
But from what I'm hearing, Kyrie ain't even picking up the phone for these motherfuckers. They calling him to find out what's going on, and he's screening calls.
He's selfish.
Yeah, so, hey, that's what y'all motherfuckers get for going from across the bridge when Knicks got the whole damn apple when we speak of New York. Y'all niggas is just the worm inside the apple. Let's keep it moving, man.
I'm from Brooklyn, too.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Let me tell you something. It's not Brooklyn. It's these Nets.
Yeah.
Brooklyn's too thorough. Y'all know Brooklyn. Come on, man. Brooklyn. Ain't nobody fronting on Brooklyn. Never. It's these goddamn Nets of
that.
All boroughs. You go to Brooklyn?
I would have, be honest with you, I would have preferred for them to keep, I would have said, fuck James Harden, and I would have loved it. We would have kept Caris LeVert and Allen. I mean, I felt like we was from 1 to 10, we had, the Nets got a squad, and we sat here and gave up James Harden. Who gonna play D now? Jared Allen was playing probably the best player on the team besides Kevin Durant. We got rid of him?
Man,
dumb
listen.
Shit.
Well, let's scratch that off, man, because I'm getting hyped talking about these motherfuckers. I'm starting to smell the stench and all that.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I'm saying? But You said something about Kevin Knox earlier. You said that you like his game. It's improved.
It's definitely improved. Gotta get more.
How do you see Kevin Knox's game when we speak of defense, though? Because I spoke to somebody. Oh, okay.
Horrible. 6'9". He should be grabbing more rebounds. You know what I mean? These guys is crazy, man. I don't understand how you 6'9", man. And you know what I don't understand? Even where's your heart, man? Where's your heart? I seen when they played the Nets last week, and I seen Kevin Durant pulling up. Like, just treat motherfuckers like babies. And they scared. You could tell. You could look at a lion always to see deer. You know what I mean? And Kevin Durant is a fucking lion. And he see deer written on him. And it's just ridiculous how these guys are just...
Well, once these Knicks get their... What you call it? Oh, I'm lost for words, man. Listen, I can't discredit anything you're saying about Kevin Durant. He's a hell of a player. But once again, they're not going nowhere over there, man.
Nah, they're not. I think they're going to the finals.
Oh, man, we're going to have to get off the subway. You're getting me mad, man. It's freezing out here. And you bringing body heat out on this motherfucker. Talking about these motherfuckers going to the finals.
I would love for the Knicks to do something, man, but I don't know what's going on with them, man. You know what I mean? You can't. I don't know what to say, man. I'm at a loss of words.
Let's talk about RJ, man. Let's get some words back in your vocal cords,
RJ Barrett.
Talk to me.
It's cool, man, but you know what I mean? I'm pissed off, man. We're supposed to have Ja Morant. Imagine Ja Morant was in the Garden as opposed to Kevin Durant. As opposed to
RJ Barrett.
Come on, man. It's not even a shot, man.
Let's critique RJ Barrett's game. What do you think he still needs? Because surprisingly,
right hand.
You know what I noticed about RJ?
That nigga don't use his right hand at all.
No, he stays on the left. But check this out.
Right hand side trying to make left hand layups. I don't understand how this motherfucker supposed to be a pro. That's what happens when you got too much. He already had a grown man body, and he was playing against kids, and he never developed. How the fuck you ain't got no right hand, bro?
Wow.
I ain't to be cursing, but come on, man.
But check this out. You know what I noticed with RJ, man?
What's that?
Is that them threes is not going down for him, man. He's not good for the three-point line. He got good looks.
Yeah.
I'm like, the best. I mean, it's not bad shots. It just don't fall. And I'm like, damn, is Vaseline on the fucking rim? Like, why is this shit not falling? But his mid-range shot.
Mid-range is good.
It's decent.
You just got to put that work in. I guess, you know what? We're going to give him the benefit of the doubt, too. He only 20 years old. You know what I mean? You're 20 years on the NBA. I guess that's just a blessing. So what we're going to do is, RJ, I'm going to give you a benefit of the doubt.
All right, my boy Mitch, talk to me.
Mitch is the man. He grabbing rebounds, blocking. He's the only consistent player on the New York Knicks.
Now, I see him improving on catching silly fouls. It looks like he's learning to keep his hands up.
It's hard for him because he's the only one that plays real defense. So it's hard for him to pick up silly fouls when you got motherfuckers blown by your guards and you got to protect the rim. You're the only rim protector. I ain't see nobody catch a block shot except for him. My fault, I'm free.
No. But Julius Randle was having steals and blocks too now.
Yeah, but still 6-4 in a row. We lost 4 in a row.
Okay. Moving right along, man. I'm gonna put some body heat because it is cold. We're gonna keep it going. But that's what you get talking about these Nets, man. Nah, we're gonna give my Nickavellian some street shit. No, I don't wanna see no brick wall. Let's keep it going though, real quick. Austin Rivers, man.
Oh, he played great. You know what I mean? He get a little shaky, but he had that one good night.
Seen that game between
Yeah, he had 13.
Where he shitted on Donovan and Mitchell. I think Donovan and Mitchell was talking.
13 points. But you know what? The Jazz played the Nets the day before. So it was like he had a back-to-back day. You know what I mean? Every dog gonna have a good day. You know what I'm saying? But you gotta realize, if you ever watched that game when they beat when the Knicks beat the Jazz that day.
Yeah.
They just played the Nets the day before.
Okay. And your boy Obi Toppins, man. Are you ready for his return, man? He been out.
I know he been out for a minute, man. I'm hoping. I didn't even get a chance to see him put on like what I thought he was gonna do. I thought he was gonna be doing more, but you know, what can you do when you got a bunch of forwards on the team? You know what I'm saying? I thought Thibodeau, but you got to earn your keep in the world. You know what I mean? And that's all you do. Sometimes you got to go through growing pains. Nothing in life should be easy.
So you saying that the Knicks got too many forwards?
We definitely got too many forwards.
So who should go?
Julius Randle should definitely go.
You serious?
Yeah. We giving him all this money for what? We not going to win with that nigga. We not going to win. We better off giving that nigga away for a trade exception or some shit. Save the money. We're gonna tank again. We ain't going to the playoffs.
Oh, you're killing me. That's why you cold, motherfucker.
Oh, man. Excuse me. The whole world.
That's why you cold, man, because you're not bringing no heat.
No, I'm
you're bringing the heat.
I'm actually warming now because I'm being honest now. I'm getting pissed off.
Yeah, talk your honesty, man.
We're not going to the playoffs.
Oh, my God.
You know what I mean? So what we should be doing is, right, let's get rid of some of all these play, like this Julius Randle, we gave him all his money. Decent guy, got no problem with him, decent ball player, but he's not gonna be, he's gonna eventually be a bench player. So what we need him for? We pay him all his money for. He gonna, hey, you put him on a real basketball team, you put him on another team, and it's straight, he's not winning anything. He's gonna be on the bench. So what do we point him, giving him a starter team minutes, a star money, and star minutes when we got a guy like Obi Toppin, we need to have a balance and we need to shrink some, and sometimes we gotta cut low to build high. And we gotta let Julius go. Julius is my man, but we gotta let him go.
And Tom Thibodeau, being the coach that he is. Is he overworking these players, man?
Nah, he's not. Actually, Tom is actually doing a great job. He's actually kind of let it loose a little bit after what happened between when he was in Chicago. You know what I'm saying? When he was in Chicago, he was actually more like dominant. You know what I mean? But this year, he's going to be a little bit more free of letting the Knicks players do what they want on offense. You know what I'm saying? And maybe he might have to pull back some because them motherfuckers can't play. Them niggas don't know how to play no offense. So you got to pull back a little bit, Tim.
All right, man.
You're doing good, though. I'm proud of you.
And my boy, Mike Woodson. Because there's a lot of talk with Tom Thibodeau. But Mike Woodson is the offensive coach. He's in the trench.
I didn't even know he was back. He back as the assistant coach?
Yeah. Mike Woodson, man. So them games that we win on offense, you gotta give him his just due, man. It ain't all Tom Dibbs. Tom Dibbs has shown the defensive end.
Offense don't win games. Defense wins games. So I don't care about no offense.
Okay, so but if you make stops and you can't score,
if I make stops, when nobody scores, we all make stops in the game and 2-0. We won 2-0. We still won. So I don't care about who had 30. I don't care if this guy can score. Can we play defense? Can you lock your man up? Can you play team defense? Can you help out? Can you rotate on defense? Those are the things that's more important. Offense is like nothing. You in the NBA, you should be able to put the ball in the hole. It's not as a reason why you're in the NBA. Fuck, Tony Campbell played for Minnesota Timberwolves back in the 90s and averaged 27, and he became a Knick and averaged 8 points a game that year. You remember that?
Okay.
Charles Smith, 21 in the Clippers, came to the NBA, went to the Knicks, but he averaged 5 points. They got a shit punch. He's the most worst Knick ever. So it's a lot of guys in there. It's niggas in the NBA that's not even NBA that got NBA scoring mentalities. We all could score. Can you play defense? Are you mentally prepared to play this game? A lot of players ain't, man, especially them young players.
And last but not least, and we out after this, Frank Ntilikina.
Oh, man, why you do me like this? This is what I'm talking about. Now I'm hot. Frank Futter ain't been getting no burns, so I'm doing what he's supposed to do. Leave Frank Futter on the side. By the end of the year, send his ass back to France.
Ah, nothing more to be said, man.
Schubavelli, I appreciate you. I appreciate you, Nicovelli.
And we out. Peace.